G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. This time round I thought we'd have a look at a rowing boat in 135 scale. I don't think I've done a boat on my channel yet, so this will be a first. And this is a very tiny one, guys, but I've looked at it for a couple of years now. And I just thought, you know, maybe for, a little diorama. I've seen so many little nice little people doing rivers on YouTube and, you know, little lakes with resin and stuff like that, that I've been thinking about it for quite some time. So I pulled the trigger and picked this one up. This one's from Reality and Scale. Let's have a quick look. Nice little box it comes in, pretty basic. You can reseal or close it if you like, which is always nice. And here are little parts here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 parts. And where's Skippy? Bring little Skippy over, just to give you the size of the boat, which is roughly around 9 centimeters long and around, let's say around 3 centimeters wide, close to 3 centimeters wide. Now, what I did like about this, if you do get the little eyelets or whatever you want to call for the oars, if you like, and yeah, I could be wrong. Funny thing about these little fellas, how do I do this? I think they're just a little bit too small for the little oars to go in, so you might have to just open that up a little bit. And I think this diameter on it will be okay. It's just that this bit here is a little bit thicker, so when you actually get it in, it'll be okay, I think. It's just this little bit here. But I'm pretty sure. So there you go. But you get those two little bits there. You get a little flotation bit there. And this is your little seat as well. That should sit in there. See just the thickness of it there. Should sit in somewhere around there. Sits nicely in there. One of those little surfaces or ridges, if you like. Here's a bit of rope, don't know if it was sharp, sort of on the end of the oars there. And not much in the way of sort of wood grain or anything like that on the ends of the oars here. Guess I'll tell you how long these are as well. And they're around 6.5 centimeters long, if you're wondering. So pretty basic little set to put together. Not too much, it's very, very subtle, but you do get a little bit of a wood grain along the edges. It might not show up, but it's very subtle, so you probably want to take your hobby knife in there and just make them a little bit more prominent. Out the back here, it's very flat and smooth. You do see some little panels, if you like, of wood along here, but again, it's very fine, so you're going to need, not as you can see down the bottom here, you can notice that a little bit more obvious, but up the top here, you're going to need to take your hobby knife and sort of run those lines out if you want to engrave them a little bit better so it looks like this. But they're at the top there and obviously around the sides, but I really like it. And I just like the size of it, and like I said, I was thinking about doing just a little diorama or something with my little boat in it. And just for show you the size, I thought I'd grab a couple of little figures. So the first little figure I thought, which is the new one from Alpine Miniatures, is beautiful, which I'll do a review on, is this little fella here. And what I thought I could do is just whack him. Let's try and sit him at the end there like this, you know, so he's just having a little bit of a rest there. And he actually sits there quite nicely, which is quite surprising given that I just random figure that I pulled out. He could actually work sitting there, apart from his back there sculpted for the swimmer wagon. So you'd have to fill that in, unfortunately. But apart from that, you know, he actually sits quite nicely in there. Especially if you've had a little bit of, you know, something on the bottom, maybe put a little tarp or something down the bottom there to squish his feet down on so they're sitting right. And totally from a different era. I thought we could go, this is another little beautiful figure as well, which I think I'll do a review on soon, from Evolution Miniatures. Two of my favourite companies there, if you're wondering, Alpine and Evolution Miniatures. My favourite two companies in 135 scale. And this little fella is absolutely beautifully sculpted as well. So makes good sense to have these two little guys together. You know, A little bromance, if you like. Just thought I'd show you this for the little for the size in 135 scale, if you're wondering. And I'll just tilt it on the side, hopefully he won't fall out. And then it gives you a bit of an idea of size. So you could easily fit two little figures in there. Possibly three if you had some little small, you know, the smaller type dragon figures or something like that. But look at that figure, such a beautifully sculpted figure. And obviously you're going to have your little bench seat in the middle here. But you could definitely have two figures here. Possibly even two on the back here if you want them sitting off the edge. Or even three possibly. But I'd say it'd be getting a little bit heavy for the little boat. This is a little quick one. This will go on my diorama playlist. If you're interested in doing a diorama, I'm doing a little playlist on my YouTube channel for diorama accessories and buildings and so forth. And I thought I'd whack this one in here. There you have it, guys. Another quick one from me. The little rowing boat from Reality in Scale. 135 scale, number 35205. Thanks a lot for watching. I'll catch you later.